What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in this video I'm going to be sharing with you my 10 tips to speed up your work inside of Revit. So without wasting any time, let's jump straight into tip number one, which is to be smart about your selections. Now this means setting up your selection options properly. This means using cross selections and then filtering those to get the categories that you want. Use all of the right click selection options, so to select multiple instances of a certain item, either in a view or in an entire project, or you have these, for example, for curtain walls where you can select a whole row of curtain wall panels and similar. Make sure to use the tab key to select a chain of walls instead of having to go through each one and select them individually. Now, I explore all of these selection tips and tricks in my video on Revit selections, which I'm going to link up in the cards above. Moving on now to tip number two, which is going to be organizing your workspace. If you're working in Revit often, it makes sense to organize your workspace. Now, it can be as simple as just moving your project browser, not to be underneath your properties panel, move it to the other side so you can have a larger project browser. If you're working on bigger projects, you're probably going to have a lot of views, and it makes sense to make it a lot easier to get to those views. Now, if you're working on a dual screen system, well, it makes sense to utilize that extra screen real estate that you have. You can undock your project browser, you can undock your properties panel, move them to the second screen to see more. And then also you have the ability to undock individual views. So if you're looking at two views at once, well, you can actually move that or move one of the views to the other screen. And that makes a lot of sense. Now, this brings us conveniently to our third tip, which is to utilize section boxes. Whenever you're working in a 3D view, it can be really difficult to see some of the elements. Something might be blocking the view. Well, if you use a section box, you can isolate only the section of the project that you're working on, and it's going to be a lot easier to actually see that part of the project and make changes. So you don't waste a lot of time trying to find the correct angle to look at a certain item. Now, tip number four brings us to using plugins. Well, Revit has a lot of tools, but Revit has a lot to offer, but Revit at the end of the day is just a platform, and we can add to that platform. And if you're working on a certain type of projects, or if you're completing certain types of tasks, it might make sense to utilize a plugin for that task instead of relying on Revit tools. For example, there is a plugin called RCCS for creating custom cabinetry in Revit. You can actually check it out on my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just above in the cards and also down in the description, so it's going to be the first link in the description. For example, this plugin allows you to create kitchens just by sketching out an elevation of a kitchen, and then it brings everything out in 3D and you can customize everything perfectly. Now, this is a plugin that saves a lot of time, whereas if you were working with regular Revit tools, you would either have to create customized families, or you would have to model in place, which is a big no-no usually. So it would waste a lot of time. So by finding a customized plugin that solves that issue, you're going to save a lot of time and you're going to save a lot of money in return. Tip number five is going to be to utilize Revit templates. Now, if you're working as part of a team or working in a larger company, usually you're going to have your own customized templates. If you're working as a solo practitioner or in a smaller company, you might not have these. Now, templates are really great. They kind of include everything that you need, and they have all of the basic settings set up for your next project. So if you don't have one, make sure to start using one. Create your own template or get a customized Revit template. Now, this can have just some of the basic settings. You might just want to include some view templates or something like that, or you can go even further and include all of the families and a lot more additional settings. Now, if you want to check out my customized Revit templates, you can find them on my website, so I'm just going to link those up in the cards above, and then also I'll include a link just below this video in the description. Now, speaking about templates, we come to our tip number 6, which is to have families ready. Now, you can have these families as part of your template, or you can have just sitting in a folder somewhere. The idea behind having ready families is you don't want to have to go online and search for families yourself, or you don't have to model the families for each particular kind of situation. You want to have everything ready, and then you can just kind of place it, and the whole workflow is going to be much quicker. I'm sure you've been there. I've been there thousands of times before, where I'm working on a project and I have just some weird family that they want to find, and I search all of the websites and I can't find it anywhere, and I spend hours of my time on something that's, well, at the end of the day, it's not that important. So you want to have those families ready, sitting there in a folder, and you can just bring them into the project. Kind of my personal tip is have them as minimalistic and simple as possible. It's going to kind of speed up your computer, because it's not going to increase the file size, and it's also not going to affect the design like a family that you might find online will. Speaking of families, this brings us to our tip number 7, which is to use adaptive families. So one of the options when it comes to Revit families is you have these adaptive families. Now, they can be simple line-based families, or they can be even more complicated adaptive families. But at the end of the day, they should do the same job, and as the name would imply, they adapt to the project. So for example, what I like to use is I like to use a storage line-based family, which just means that I have like a built-in wardrobe or closet as a family, and it's a line-based family, so you just click once, click a second time, and in between those two points, I have a built-in wardrobe. So this saves me a ton of time. Instead of having to load in a family and then adjust the width of that family, measure the distances, and so on and so forth, it's just a couple of clicks and you're done. So you should definitely look into either creating these families yourself or finding them online and using them in your projects. Next, step number 8 is to optimize your files for speed. So if you're working on a slower computer, or if you're working on an extremely large project, the file size is really going to affect the speed at which you can make edits on your Revit project. Because of this, I like to turn off everything I don't need. So turning off shadows, turning off smooth lines, deleting heavy families, especially non-Revit imported geometry, these things tend to be heavy. So just remove all of that. Anything that you don't need, just remove it. Avoid realistic views, and so on and so forth. So you want to kind of trim everything down and make sure that Revit is running quickly and smoothly so you can make changes quicker. Moving on to tip number 9, which is kind of a no-brainer, which is use Revit shortcuts. So for all of the tools in Revit, it doesn't really make sense to go through the menus, go through the tabs and panels, and find individual tools. For a lot of common tools, we have shortcuts. Now, if you haven't used shortcuts so far, or if you don't know shortcuts for some of the tools, you have two options. One would be when you want to select a certain tool, you find a tool, you hover over it, and it's going to display the shortcut for that tool. That way you can learn the shortcuts and just use the shortcuts instead of clicking on the tool. Alternatively, you can just print out a list of shortcuts or have it on a second screen and try to use that instead of searching for each tool individually. It's going to be hard at first, but over time, I think it will speed up your workflow significantly. I have a whole video on customizing shortcuts in Revit, so if you want to check that out, I'm going to link it up in the cards above. And finally, we're at tip number 10, which is probably the most important tip, and that's don't overmodel. Push things to the limit of what's practical instead of what's possible. There are no rewards for overworking. I think this is really important, especially when you're starting out. People tend to try to model everything in Revit, especially if you're migrating from AutoCAD and now you have the ability to have everything in 3D and you want to use that. Well, in some cases you just shouldn't. It just doesn't make sense to model some things. In some cases, a drafting view will be fine. In other cases, some details detail lines will do the trick. You don't have to model everything. You don't have to overmodel everything. You're not going to get extra rewards for that extra work if it's not necessary. So that's, I guess, the most important tip here is just don't overdo it. Do exactly as much as it's required for the project for everything to be done efficiently. And that concludes my 10 tips to improve your speed in Revit. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please tell me in the comment section below, do you have some tips? Is there something that you have learned along the way for working in Revit? So I'm interested in hearing that. And of course, if you want to check out all of my Revit courses, check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I've got over 142 hours of content and I'm adding more videos each month. We have just released a new course on materials in Revit, so you might want to check that out. I'm also going to link that up in the description, just the first link in the description of this video.